Well, joining me now is the former Metropolitan Police Chief Superintendent Kevin Hurley. Put this event into proportion for us, if you can.
Oh, the only way you're going to deal with this is to have a social intervention that gets upstream and helps manage the problems that come from single parenting, particularly amongst young African Caribbean women. And I'm talking about intervening and supporting families when the children are 3 and 4 years of age, to prevent them going down this route of rebelliousness and often offending. Because you can sanction the police, you can put cameras on them, you can investigate them as much as you like, but in the end, police only react to what goes on in front of their faces. We've got into this kind of vicious circle of police officers dealing with young black people who always come from a perspective that the police are there to suppress them. And the police very quickly start to learn that dealing with young black people is quite frankly aggravation and puts their mortgages and careers at risk. That's the reason, actually, why so many black youth are killing each other in London, because a lot of police officers are given up on trying to stop them carrying knives and guns to kill each other.
Do you think it is really helpful at this time of heightened concern over Black Lives Matter to see this so clearly in racial terms?
Well, I don't think, that's why I was at pains to say we need to get upstream of the problem and help with the parenting. Because this is actually not a BAME issue. This is an issue relating to people of West African heritage in terms of the relationships between police and the public. There is a real lot of misinformation going on about police officers killing black people in custody. Last year, 16 people died for various reasons in police custody, generally drug overdoses. Of those 16, only one was black. Last year, police shot 3 people dead. Only one of those were black. There is a real narrative that's going on here, I think driven by people within the Black Lives Matter movement who want to destabilise and disrupt society.
Okay, so we're going to have to leave it there. Thank you very much indeed.